Hey guys, in this video, I'm gonna show you how to create a WordPress website from 1&1.com hosting company. It's very easy. I've been using 1&1.com hosting company for a while now. It's a great hosting company. The pricing is pretty great, and the website is very reliable. The controller panel is very simple to use, and the customer service is pretty awesome. It's a good company. So first thing you have to do is go to 1&1.com website, and you have to log in to their control panel. Go and log in. It will take you to the login site, login page, and then go and put your customer ID and password. When you sign up for their hosting company, they should give you all that stuff. So you should be able to log in. If you don't know their password and customer ID, you gotta call them out and find out what's happening, because they should give you all that stuff. This is their control panel, very easy to use. Now you just scroll down to hosting section, and there should be a section called WordPress. To click there, and then they will walk you through this simple wizard. Put your website title. All these things are, you could change it later, so you could just go and put whatever you have to put. I'm just gonna put down my website just for testing, and then click create website. This is the important part. You have to create a one administrator's login. So go ahead and put a, one thing you want to do is you don't want to put admin or anything like administrator. Create something unusual and off the wall. Here I'm just going to put a Sam the Man. And then make sure you create your password. Something that's kind of difficult to figure out. Something that's kind of long and repeat password, and then you check this box and continue. Okay, so here you want to go with install WordPress. I think this managed WordPress is a service, you have to pay for it. So if you want to pay for this service, you can go and do that. But if you don't want to, we could just go and press install WordPress. And then select your domain. You should be able to have at least one domain name when you sign up for the hosting company. So go and put that in there. If you don't want to use a main domain name, you could. There's also a temporary domain name you could use, but I would just go with the main domain name and assign domain. Setting up the database and configuring the WordPress site. So this, here it is, it's complete. You could have more than one WordPress install. So here, as you can see, I have another copy of WordPress install. And of course, this one has a main domain name installed in it. So if you want to go and check, you could go to the domain name. Here we are, brand new WordPress setup, very simple. And that's pretty much it.